stop the spread of COVID. Follow the instructions which are listed below. Hope you all are staying healthy and safe. With the very positive note, I'm going to start second sem. A very good morning to one and all. So today we are going to start the first chapter of second semester under the food chemistry topic. So in today's class, we are going to study about the definition of food chemistry and the composition of food along with the definition of water. So food chemistry, as the name indicates, it is nothing but the branch of chemistry which deals with the biochemical nature of the food and their properties and how they will be processed inside our body. So nothing but it involves the study of all the chemical components starting from protein to carbohydrates. So in food chemistry, we will be learning how the different processes of technologies will affect the type of food and also how different ways are used to enhance the quality of the food. So food chemistry is defined as the study of chemical process and interaction of all biological and non-biological components of the food. Next is composition of food, nothing but what food is made up of. You know that any material which is edible or eatable and help the body to work properly is called food. And basically food is made up of many nutrients. You have already studied, that is carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, vitamins, minerals and water. So let us briefly study about one by one nutrients. The first one is carbohydrate. So they are nothing but the organic compounds which are made up of carbon, hydrogen as well as oxygen. And the function of carbohydrate is to provide energy, and 1 gram of carbohydrate will provide you 4 kilocalories of energy. And all the sugar substance whatever you will consume are the best source of carbohydrates, and whatever excess of carbohydrates are there, it will be converted into fat and it will be stored in the body. These carbohydrates will be divided into 4 categories based on the number of sugar units present in it. So it can be monosaccharides if single sugar unit is there, disaccharide if 2 are there, oligosaccharide if 10 or below 10 are there, and polysaccharide if more sugar units are there. Example for monosaccharides are glucose, fructose, galactose, etc. Disaccharides are lactose, sucrose and malt. Oligosaccharides are raffinose and stachyose, and they are largely found in dried beans, and these are not easily digested by digestive tract. Next is polysaccharides. Examples include starch, dextrin, glycogen and plant fiber components. So about starch, you'll be studying again in unit 2, that is 2 forms are starch, amylose and amylopectin. The starch molecules are partially broken either with the help of acid or heat or enzymes to give the product called dextrins, and these dextrins are having less plant fiber components. They are also called as dietary fibers. So they are nothing but the part of the food which provide fibrous content to our body. So even though they do not provide any nutrients, it is mainly helpful to remove undigested food. Include cellulose, hemicellulose, pectin substances, vegetable gums, beta glucans, etc. The second essential nutrient is protein, and protein will make up to 3/4 of our body tissues, and these proteins are majorly made up of amino acids. So animal proteins are called first class proteins because they are having almost all essential amino acids, whereas plant proteins are called second class amino proteins because they do not have all the essential amino acid. And few best example of proteins are the milk, the meat proteins, peanut, etc. So protein is made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and sulfur, and the amino acids in the protein are linked together with the help of peptide bonds. and the quality of the protein depends on the essential amino acids present. If all the 9 essential amino acids listed below, if it is present, it is said to be a complete protein. The next essential nutrient is fat, and fat will supply necessary fatty acids and glycerol that the body can only get from the food. So these fat will act as a storage site for excess of calories, and whenever our body requires energy and the carbohydrate is over, one fat molecule can be taken, because one fat will give us 9 kilocalories of energy. Fats are insoluble in water and it feels greasy or oily. The major three groups are triglycerides, phospholipids and sterols. Coming to triglycerides, as the name indicates, it is made up of one glycerol molecule and three fatty acid molecules, and around 90-95% of fatty substance are found in food. Most fatty acids in food are combined in triglycerides, and the number of hydrogen and the length of carbon differs in fatty acids, and always the carbon numbers are even. Coming to type of fatty acids, it can be saturated and unsaturated. Saturated means which is having single bond, unsaturated is having double bond. So unsaturated can be monounsaturated or polyunsaturated. Monounsaturated means having one double bond, polyunsaturated means having more than one double bonds. So omega-3 fatty acid is one of the example for polyunsaturated fatty acid, which is mainly found in fish oil and it is very good for heart. The next one is linoleic acid. It is a type of essential fatty acid. This cannot be synthesized by body but should be consumed in the form of food and majorly found in cooking oils. Next is phospholipids. So compared to triglycerides, they are found in less amount in food and they act as emulsifiers, nothing but helps in preparing oil and water emulsions. Example is lecithin. So after triglycerides and phospholipids, next is sterols. It can be cholesterol or plant sterols. So cholesterol, also known as animal sterols, and they are found only in animals, and it is associated with coronary heart disease. And our body can prepare cholesterol with the help of vitamin D. Then plant sterols are also called as phytosterols, and it will interfere with the absorption of cholesterol in the body. And the next important constituent or component of food is water. And the typical suggestion is 6 to 8 glasses of liquid per every day. And in food, how water will be present, that will be discussed in next class. The next component is minerals. So minerals are the nutrients which are required for basic metabolic activities like functioning of heart or digestive system, bone formation, etc. So they can be of two forms, that is major minerals and minor minerals, or macro and micro minerals. Example includes calcium, copper, iron, magnesium, phosphorus, etc. Next is vitamins. As the name indicates, they are the vital amines which our body requires for the functioning and for regulating the normal process. So most of the vitamins are obtained from the food. It can be of two types, the fat soluble vitamins and water soluble vitamins. So each vitamin will have its own function in the body, and if the diet is having any deficiency, it may lead to any diseases or disorders. So water is abundant in all living things, in almost all food, unless steps have been taken to remove it. So most of the natural food contains around 70% of their weight unless they are dehydrated, and most of the fruits and vegetables contains up to 90% of the water. This water, either it can be as an intracellular or extracellular form in vegetables and animal products, or it can be present as a dispersing or as a dispersed phase in many of the emulsifier products like butter or margarine, or it can be present as a minor constituent in some of the foods. So in food, water is defined as water activity or in the form of water activity. So the presence of water in food is described as the moisture content or water activity.
So moisture is nothing but how much amount of water is present, and water activity is nothing but in which form water exists in the food. So water content in some of the food is mentioned below. So you can see that in fresh fruits and vegetables the water is rich, whereas in other dry fruits and food products it is less because of the processing. So that is for today's class. So in today's class we have learnt about the definition of food chemistry, nothing but the biochemical interaction of the food and their properties and how they'll be processed inside the body. Also we have listed out what are the components or constituents of the food, nothing but carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, their types, vitamins, minerals and the water. And also we have studied about the water activity, nothing but the amount of water present or the form of water present in the food. Thank you students, and for this sem onwards student work will be 60% and teacher work will be 40%. That is, you should only prepare the notes. Reference sources will be provided, or you have to search for it, and you have to prepare your own notes. And if any doubts are there, you can message me personally. And daily attendance will be taken, so keep it in mind and attend the classes regularly.